Okay, deep breath. 3, 2.
So I grew up in St. Louis, and I was there until third grade, and I moved here in fourth grade. And it was probably the best decision of my life to move here because I met a lot of new people and new friends. This is my family. I used to live with my dad, but last year I decided to move out of his house and to with my mother. Family means a lot to me because they are always there to support me and pick you up when you're down. I have an older sister, she's 20, and every time I see her, we always have fun and we always laugh. And she moved in with her boyfriend, so I don't really get to see her that much. And I have a younger brother, and he's 6. He's the biggest brat in the world. But I love him. And I hardly get to see him because he lives with his mom. And I don't speak to her anymore. Here's my pets. At my dad's house, I have 2 dogs. And the one at the top, her name is Cody. She's 16 years old, so she's still got a lot of life on her.
You took good care of her. Wow.
And the one in the middle, her name's Bear. She is Great Dane and Black Lab mix. She's very, very hyper. And in the bottom is my cat. We were going to name her Snickers, but when you call a cat, you say, "Here, kitty, kitty." So we just call her Kitty. I really like to travel. I've been to quite a few places. I've been to Chicago over St. Patrick's Day when they dyed the river green, which is pretty cool to see. I've been to Detroit Tigers baseball game, which I'm not a big baseball fan, but my boyfriend and I go with them. I've been to Arizona because my uncle lives there and they just had a new baby. And the last picture is of the lake. We camp on Tubbs Lake, and it's really pretty. They have like 6 lakes connected together. And we don't really camp there much now because my dad's kind of got away from that. But the biggest trip that I've ever went on was Germany. And when I decided to go, my mom was very against it. I think it was because it was a lot of money, and she didn't want me going to another country.
What ballpark? Do you remember what it cost, like, to go?
Like $1,500, I think, okay. Or something like that. It was very hard for me to leave because I was missing my family for 2 weeks, but my mom got over it eventually. The plane ride over there was very, very long, but we had a TV, so we could watch movies. And I put a picture of the plane food on there because it was the most disgusting thing I've ever had.
What was it?
It was chicken with mashed potatoes and some vegetables, but it had some sauce on it and it just made it sick. The only good thing was cooking. When we got there, the first day, we went to their school, and it's very different from ours. As you can see, the lockers are very colorful and small. And I thought their keyboards were kind of cool because they speak a different language, so of course the keyboards are going to be different. And the seniors wrote their names on these clay pieces, which I thought was pretty cool. We should do that here, I think. And they do use chalkboards over there instead of markers. And we've seen a lot of buildings, and they were old and made out of brick and stone, which you don't see much of them here. And they were very, very big. And this is a Berlin Wall, which I thought was very cool. See, there wasn't much left of it standing, but it was still cool to see much of it. And there was a lot of graffiti on it, and they tried to keep it protected, but I guess it didn't work. This is called the Brandenburg Gate, and it was people passed through it to like try to get to East Germany to West Germany. And the crosses were to remember the people that had fallen when they were trying to cross over the Berlin Wall. This is one of the churches we went into. They're so big and old and a lot of spires. The also went to the Baltic Sea, and it was very, very cold, but it was cool to see a sea. The German Shepherd gave us mustaches on the day we went to the Baltic Sea, and that is my German with mustaches all over my face. This is their government building, and their government is very, very different from ours. And we actually got to sit in their seats where they do conferencing and stuff. This is just one of the castles we went into, and the King's Throne was in there, which was very awesome to see. And the floors of the castle, they made them look like optical illusions.
Cuber.
This was a memorial of a concentration camp. It was very sad, and they made the stones like that because they put the names on the stones to remember the people who had died. And I came home with a lot of chocolate and definitely a lot of memories.
Cool.